don't know if it's visible, but there's this marvelous streaking or ribbing to the sky here at the rest area of the island. And boy, do I have a story. Something went flying out of the window of my Jeep. I actually was able to go back and get it on the side of the road. There it is in the back. We're missing a lid. Sorry. Yeah, that was me.
So what happened is that somewhere between Verona, New York, and Westmoreland, New York, this container went flying, or was sucked, that's a better word, out of my Jeep. I first realized something was wrong. I was sensing a change in air pressure with a vibrant kind of sound. And I looked through my rear window, and the blue lid had just left the vehicle and landed on the thruway. This isn't the actual lid, by the way. This is one for a matching unit that I happen to have. But I look out the window, and there goes the lid. And I was like, oh, no. Because it's an object in the highway, and that's a bad thing. And I was like, well, you know, I've got another lid just like it at home. I can live with it. But as I drove on, I got this sinking feeling that there was something missing. And I looked back, and I finally got off at the rest area just before Westmoreland, New York, on the thruway, and realized that the whole box had gone sailing out of the vehicle onto the New York State Thruway. And I hadn't realized it at all. I was absorbed in my driving and thinking about other things and didn't realize that I'd rolled the windows down completely in the back. And in the box is a Remco NASA space set heavy gauge steel gear. It survived. The bottom of the box has no damage. I got off at Westmoreland, turned around, drove back to Canastota, New York, an exit later, after the Verona, New York, I remembered. Yeah, I almost turned up into a rest area, a service center, but a rest area to make sure everything was okay. So it happened somewhere between the exit and there. And sure enough, I come driving up the road, and there it is on the side of the road. Not only was I concerned about it being an object potentially in the highway, I wasn't even, it wouldn't in my wildest dreams have imagined that I'd retain it back intact, but it had this Tente fishing trawler construction toy that I've had since I was 10 years old. I'm not making that up. And I was like, I don't want to say that's the real reason why I turned around, but there were two thoughts that were on my mind as I was first driving west back to Canastota and then east again from Canastota. Was that A, I don't need to get a ticket for littering on the thruway, and B, man, I'm going to be bummed out to know that this thing is gone, even more than the space shuttle. I hate the space shuttle. I'm going to hate it even more after this, but props to Remco for coming up with a decent packaging. I don't know how it stayed in the box. When I finally found it along the side of the thruway, it was sitting up like this, lid gone. The lid's long gone. And this was lying a few feet off to the side. And they were just sitting there, slowed down to 65. Put on the hazards, backed up, ran out, grabbed them, threw them in the back, and drove off thinking, what the heck just happened? And I'd wanted to bring it back so I could sort of remate its various components. The reason why I got it is that it had these nifty little spaceman forms in it, with the hoses. I like that kind of stuff. And the price for the whole thing was ridiculously low. Oh, yeah, and you get the jet, too. And there's a truck comes with it. That goes up here. And the other thing that is really cool about it is the rocket gantry. And I wanted to remarry the whole set together. I'll have to dig out the fighter jet. There it is. Actually, it's actually a nice little thing. Labels are peeling up, and thinking they're going to figure out a way to put the labels back on. But I kind of wanted to see it all back together again with this sort of, you know, new old stock packaging thing. And was kicking myself once I realized it was gone. It ended up on the top of everything because it was like, I grabbed it at the last minute. I'm like, you know what, I'm going to bring this too. I want all my stuff. And I put this in it to want to keep it from getting crunched by, say, being stuffed into a backpack or whatever. I was kicking myself for having done it. And it survived. It survived. The lid's gone. There's one from another set that fits it, and indeed it's broken as well. But, you know, props to, what is that, Bella Contemporary Storage. I'm sure I got it at a dollar store somewhere. There we go. It survived. It protected the piece. It didn't. It's not destroyed. It is. I guess it's in as good a shape as it was when I put it in the container this morning before leaving Syracuse. But that's what happened. And I mean, the only thing that I can say in my defense, and I'll put it back together, I had not taken the potential aerodynamic lift of this form into mind when I loaded up the Jeep, where I would have put it underneath something else, and we'll be much more careful about my back windows being. I've only had the thing now for about 3 weeks, and I've never had anything go sailing out the windows before in my entire life, except when John Fishman threw my hat out of the school bus window on the way home from school one day. And yeah, that John Fishman. He remembers it, and so do I. Anyway, there we go. I got my, it was recovered. And, you know, I got my Tente. It was incomplete, but you check, secure your loads and keep your windows rolled up. All right, we got space buckets.